Oh, here we go. We did all right. All right, so we're back at the Downhill Southeast.
Oh, no.
Introduce yourself.
I'm Sean Kelly.
Good?
Damn good. She's slick, boy.
How'd it feel, buddy?
Good.
Yeah, you tucked better this time.
Yeah, I feel like I kind of like nose heavy on that. Dude. Just a little bit.
Good job, brother.
Thank you.
Yeah, well, on the steep part.
Yo! What up, boys? Whoa. Good job.
Come on, son.
He got it. And he's gonna send it. Watch him. Watch him. Yeah.
What was that?
Huh?
What was that?
I clipped a paddle going off the step down.
Oh, wow.
I got it.
Oh, yeah. Sick.
Hey, Dirk.
wheels of the Silver Bullet. They'll get you to the top. Let's see what Khan's got. Last rider down. Khan goes into seventh with a 3:05. So Dakota Norton going to take the win. Downhill Southeast, round number one. Followed by Lucas Shaw in second. Nico Mullally in third. Walker Shaw in fourth. And Showtime Nathan St. Clair rounding it out in fifth.
Alright, so we're back at the Downhill Southeast.
Oh no.
Introduce yourself.
I'm Sean Kelly.
And how'd you do today?
I think I got 16th in front.
That's mighty fine, sir. Mighty fine.
Trying. Learning. To learn how to ride a bike. I gotta learn how to corner.
Did you like the track?
Yeah, dude. The track was wicked fun. It's like perfect. It was a pure dirt when we came down. So it was awesome. The corners stuck really well and the bike stayed on the ground. It was fun.
Good, man. What kind of... On a scale of 1 to 10, what do you think your race was? Like, when? Like, are you consistent?
Dude,
it's
just the first dry race this season. And first dry race on a real downhill bike. I rode on a trail bike last year. So, it's like the best run I've ever had on a downhill bike. So, I'm learning. Like I said, got a lot of process.
Yeah. Well, that's good, man. 16th. That's solid.
Thanks, buddy. Appreciate it.
And we are live here, Downhill Southeast. We have Logan Mullally here. And you did a little something spicy in your race run. Can we hear about that?
Yeah, I've been hearing about it all weekend. Old Isaac Levison over there has been really pushing me to do this.
We got to get him over here. We need to... So you're the man behind
the motivational speaker
on the act that happened in the race run. So how do you push him to do it? Well, first of all, he did a backflip, so we'll get there. But how do you push him to do it?
I don't know. He knows how to do it. So I'm just gonna tell him he knows how to do it.
Just say, dude, just pull it.
Yeah.
And just win the hearts of all the fans.
I mean, honestly, we were just like, it'd be really cool. And it was.
Yeah. So how did it feel like mid-race run just backflip?
It felt perfect. Didn't even think about it. It was great. It was, got me really pumped up to pedal into the finish.
That's awesome. You still got fifth?
No, I think I was maybe 7th or 8th. Last few guys came down and really put some time into me.
But still, with a backflip, you can't really complain with a spot like that.
I can't complain. I was stoked on it.
That's it. So I'm sure they'll have a little check up there for the best of show for you.
I sure hope they do.
All right, man. I appreciate it.
Thank you, guys.
Have a good one. All right, so we are with a man that does not do interviews, but he does take great pictures. John, how's it going?
It's doing great. Thank you.
Having a good time this weekend?
We are having a fabulous time. It has been great, nice dry weather compared to the last few times we've been out here. A little wet today, but it's still great.
You grab a good couple good shots?
One or two probably. Nice.
Yeah, I saw you out there taking some good angles. You look good. So yeah, had fun. That's the important part.
That is pretty good. I appreciate it. Thank you.
All right, man. You have a good one now.
All right, you too.
At the Downhill Southeast at Windrock, updating again with my man Walker. How's it going?
Good, how are you?
Doing good, man. So you are 11, right?
Yes, sir.
And we all witnessed you hitting the Red Bull Ravine, step down and step up. Talk us through it.
It's pretty easy. You just gotta do it. It's fun. Yeah.
So if I have a friend that, you know, I'm not gonna say any names, but if I have a friend that won't hit it, what's a tip to convince him to do it?
You can't really over jump it because the landing's really big, so you just gotta pedal a lot. So yeah.
Just do it.
Yeah, just do it.
It feels really cool to, you know, get over the stuff that all these pros are getting over and you're hitting it and a lot of people aren't.
Yes, sir.
You having fun out here?
Yes, sir.
Cool. And how do you do this weekend?
I got 9th out of 16, I think.
That's good, man. That's good. What category were you racing in?
14 and under.
Okay, so that's a pretty stacked category.
Yes, sir.
That's awesome, man. Well, I'm glad you had fun this weekend. It was a pleasure to interview you. And hope to see you out at more races.
Yes, sir. Thank you.
Yeah, man.
Dude. Yeah.
Brittany is filming the GOAT.
All right. We're back with another...
The GOAT.
Wait.
Oh.
Hold on. Should we have otter in it?
Yeah, sure.
Okay.
All right, so we are back interviewing. We got cars moving everywhere, but that's fine. Introduce yourself.
Savannah Rogers.
And this is your first downhill race?
Yes.
And first time at Windrock in general?
Yes. Yep, first time.
And how did it end up for you?
I fell a lot. I didn't cry though during the race.
Just afterwards?
Before.
Before?
Before, during practice, I had a panic attack. I was like, they said this was gonna be like a user-friendly course. It wasn't.
It wasn't?
No, there were not the ride-arounds that we were promised.
I can see that. I can see that. Do you know where you ended up?
Dead last.
Did you have fun?
Not really.
So basically, this interview's over. That's a wash right there.
I'm gonna do it again. But this was like a real rough start. It's fine.
So you'll be back at another downhill Southeast?
Yeah, I'm probably gonna be at Massanutten.
Massanutten.
Are you?
I'll be there.
Will you be there?
We'll be there.
He's gonna be there.
Cool.
So you better be prepared.
I don't know if I'll be spectating or racing, but we'll see.
Either or, you're gonna get another interview, so be prepared for it.
I will be prepared. Hopefully I get a day to practice there.
Otter out.
This is the real star.
Yeah, zoom in on that. So, how was it hanging out in Tennessee today? And do you like all the other dogs that showed up? Bam.
He's very excited.
This interview's out. He's done. We are at the Downhill Southeast here in Tennessee at Windrock, and we have the whole Santa Cruz Trek, Santa Cruz Olin team manager. We got everybody out here.
Honestly, team Kaylee Smith Racing.
Yeah, it's a party out here.
Girls so we have shred.
Girls Who Shred.
Girls Who Shred. Hashtag it. So we're out here. Look so we have up. Walker Shaw.
Yes.
Kaylee.
Luca.
And Luca. Yeah. And you can say your name if you want to, too.
I'm Walker.
There you go. So we'll start. Who wants to start first?
I'll start.
Okay. So we're with Luca Shaw. He's starting first. How was your race round?
It was really good. Yeah, track was primo, so had fun.
Nice. And you like riding out here a lot?
Yeah. Yeah, this is probably one of the better weekends we've had with like weather and conditions wise. So the tracks are always good, but it was also pleasant, so, which is kind of rare. So it was good.
That's good, man. Yeah, so you were looking fast, and you got, what place did you get?
Second.
That's a good number, man. I like the number,
yeah,
too.
Yeah, it matches my number plate, so, yeah, just meant to be.
Meant to be the whole weekend. So, mm-hmm. And I see you're on a new little sponsorship going on here for this year.
Yeah.
You liking it?
Yeah.
Now, the real question is, how much of it do you drink?
Lots. Too much.
Really?
Yeah.
It's like a little addiction.
Yeah. Yeah. Big, like, I got a sweet tooth, so the sugar just,
oof. This is perfect. Yeah. Especially on a nice, hot, sunny day like today, just crack a cold monster.
But nothing quenches your thirst quite like that, so.
And for all you that don't know, he just got paid off of that right there. The advertisement is just.
I know what you're all about.
Sweet, man. Well, it was good to see you out here. And
yeah, good to see you guys.
Yeah, man. Thanks. We're on to the next. So I heard that
exit
this is
stage.
Exit stage right over there, my man. So I heard this is your.
That's nice.
We're matching.
Oh yeah.
Yeah. So I heard this is your first downhill race. Is that true?
Yeah.
Did you like it?
Yes.
Is this your first time racing in America?
No, I've done the World Cups in wintertime before.
Oh, okay, right, yeah.
Yeah,
but
cross-country.
Cross-country, but this is like completely different?
Yeah, completely.
So did you like the track? Was it fun?
Yeah, it was really cool. I mean, it was never really a big plan that I will do that, but since Luca did it, I came along, and it was a lot of fun. I didn't have a downhill bike today, but I was on the slash, but it was cool. It was perfect.
That's awesome. So you think you're going to make a transition from cross-country to downhill?
No.
You're going to stick with the cross-country?
Yeah, I think so.
Okay, awesome. Good to see you and Kinker.
Thank you.
Lucky, have good luck this
Thank
season.
Thank you. Thanks a lot.
We are with team manager. How's it going?
Good.
So what are some of your responsibilities for this weekend, keeping everything rolling?
Well, I always make sure there's water around and I help them choose the right lines.
Oh, so you're responsible for the outcome of the race, basically.
Basically.
Essentially.
Yeah. Essentially,
putting a lot of weight on the shoulder. Oh,
yeah.
Okay.
Yeah.
So you should be up on the podium instead of Luca.
Yes.
You should be helping pack the race truck.
Oh. Pack the race truck is their job, though. Because you made them, you got them
a
second.
I helped them through the weekend, so.
Your job's done.
Now it's their job.
Shots are fired out here. Well, good to see you out here, and
you
thanks
too.
For the interview.
You're welcome.
And I hope you have a good one.
You too.
All right, now onto the big man himself.
What's up? How we doing?
How's it going, man?
It's going pretty good. It's sunny at Windrock. I think that's a first, so yeah, it's all good. Good weekend. good time.
And you're on a freshly built bike. I think the last time we saw you, you were on the demo.
Yeah, I was on a, I was on a demo last year. Luca was nice enough to let me use one of his old bikes for the Pro GRT. So that was a good time. But yeah, built that up about 2 weeks ago. Did a couple runs on it last weekend here. But yeah, this was the first race. I loved it. So.
Yeah, you're looking looking pretty sturdy on that old
bike. Appreciate it. Yeah, it's weird. I was on one of Lucas' old bikes. You just get used to like whatever you're riding, so it feels good to be on like a bike that fits me.
Yeah,
like, makes a pretty big difference.
Yeah, and if I'm not mistaken, Angelo and I were out there filming, and we got a little clip of you coming off of the rock gap and jumping the step up afterwards.
Off of the rock gap.
Well, like the rock step down.
Yeah.
And you were hooting and hollering a little bit. Was it just a little mistake up top, or were you just having fun?
I think I was just having fun. I don't really remember that. So, yeah, I don't know. It was running fast, so maybe,
It was a U and a yee.
Yeah, maybe I thought I saw someone on the track. I'm not sure. But yeah, it was a good time.
Yeah.
Hard to control the excitement.
Yeah, and you seem to maybe ride better when you're having a good time.
Yeah, I'd say the more relaxed I am, the better. So, yeah, working on that.
Yeah, I saw the video that you posted through the loops, and you were like, going terrifyingly fast.
Appreciate it. Yeah, those are kind of scary, so I think the faster you can get through them, the quicker they're over.
Yeah. So, well, good to see you, man. You're looking good. And
thanks, boys.
One last question. Yeah. Where did you end up on the end of the day?
I think I was fourth, so, yeah.
So, brothers on the podium.
Yeah, for sure. It was a good day. Yeah, we had fun.
That's sick. All right, dude.
Thanks,
good
boys.
Seeing you, man.
We got
a little interview to go.
A little interview? I heard you guys put some internet videos up, and I watch them while I'm on my roller in the morning sometimes.
Yeah. See, we have a fan.
I'm a fan of the show. I'm a fan of the show.
So here we are. We're at the Downhill Southeast at Windrock, and we are with our winner, Dakota Norton. How'd it feel, man?
Yeah, that was cool, man. I haven't raced since Worlds at Lenzerheide last year, and I went through a big shoulder surgery, so it's good to be back on my bike overall and then be back knowing I can go fast with some of the heavy hitters on the World Cup schedule.
Yeah, you're flying. So first race back, and it's a win. Do you think that'll set the tone for the rest of the season?
Yeah, I was really nervous today, and it was good to know that when I got in the gate, I could turn my head off and I could execute the way I wanted to. So I think I can take that. I mean, anytime you get in the starting gate, it's a race. I don't want to get beat by anybody. You know, that's the mentality that we all have. So knowing that I can shut my head off and execute under pressure is good going into the first World Cup.
That's awesome, dude. Congrats, and you were on a burner, so yeah. Good to see you back.
Thank you so much. Appreciate it.
Good one, man. All right, cool.
Are we on the YouTube channel?
We will be on the YouTube.
Sick.
So, we are out here, Downhill Southeast, with Mr. Downhill Southeast himself. How's it going, Neko?
It's going great, dude. We had perfect weather. That dirt was awesome for the race today.
It was super killer. It was really dusty yesterday. Rained a lot.
Would you have imagined that 2 weeks ago? It was really dusty yesterday?
No.
Like, if you were here at the GRT, would you have ever imagined this place dusty, like, 12 days later?
No. I would still imagine ruts everywhere, like, really deep.
We got all conditions at the run.
We got all the conditions. So, going back to the dusty, but turned out to be perfect track conditions, how'd your race run go?
Dude, it went really good. Honestly, like, this trail is probably my least favorite here. Well, it's fun to ride, but I'm not good at it. So I tried to make a track that was, like, really the things I needed to practice. So I was 3 seconds off Dakota and, like, one off Luca. So I was pumped. Like, honestly, I rode the turns really good. I'm not good at riding those, like, slap berms. Like, I'm more of a gnarly rock kind of guy, not a slap berm kind of guy.
Yeah, so, kind of. You like the sweeping.
Well, I like just the raw, natural, not the nice berms. Anyway, fitting a big bike through there is pretty tough. I'm not good at it, so I was pretty stoked, honestly. Like, those two dudes are flying, and I was right on them, so I'm stoked.
Yeah, good run, dude, and you definitely were hauling it this weekend. So, and I have one question. How did you find out that little sneaky line on the step up?
Well, Dakota was doing it, so then I had to do it. It was taped off at the National because I knew everybody would do it. But I didn't tape the course, and they like left it open, so you had to jump off the side. Like, that's a trick jump, it's not a race jump, so it's pretty hard to go that fast over,
yep.
Especially in the dry. Like, it was kind of built to work in the winter when it was softer, and now that it's so hard packed, like, you go way too fast into it. So. Going, scrubbing jumps that are too small is way harder than jumping jumps that are too big. You'd rather pull up than scrub.
Right.
So, you gotta figure out how to carry the trajectory when the jump's peaked out. That's hard.
Yeah.
So you gotta cut the corner.
And another amazing line, jumping the rocks before Snake Rock. Do you know what I'm talking about?
Oh yeah, that was pretty gnarly. Honestly, I didn't want to do it, and then first day of practice, Dakota did it, and I was like, fuck, now we gotta do it. Now everyone's got to do it. But that's how it works. Like, that's why we do this. That's why we get all these fast guys to come and race. Like, Luca and Dakota are my buddies, and I can get them to come do it. And you know, as soon as one of those guys starts doing something, then it's like, well, that's the level now. That's the bar's been raised. We got to do it, too. So that's why we do it.
So it's not really a bad influence, but good influence, just pushing each other to just go fast.
Yeah, for sure. It's a good influence, but you'd rather figure that shit out here than at Maribor in 2 weeks or
right.
3 weeks. Like, you don't want to get caught with your pants down there.
Right. Cool. Well, thanks for the interview, man. It was good talking to you and great event. Can't wait for the next one.
Yeah, dude. Thank you guys for coming to all of them. It's awesome.
Yeah, man. We try.
Sweet.
All right. We are signing off from the first round of the Downhill Southeast here. The wonderful blown up sign there. Everyone was going fast. The track turned out to be great, great condition and really tacky and not dusty and crazy like it was. So we are signing off from here. Bam is out, and we will see you at the next one.